I am surprised that so many people think that I set out to make a statement, because I'm not really a political person. But what I've done has brought forward the opinions of a lot of parents and children of what they want to see in toys. A lot of them are secondhand Bratz dolls. What Tree Change Dolls is all about is giving some old toys a more down-to-earth, natural-looking style.
She's accidentally sort of tapped into this debate around the hypersexualisation of dolls and children's toys. And
it was kind of crazy with all the dark makeup and the giant lips.
Probably nicer to play with them. You can kind of think they're the same age as you.
And I've just been overwhelmed with the responses from people. I did not expect them to go viral. After the video was made, my dolls went even more viral than they were already. So I thought I'd gone viral, and then when this video got shared, it went viral on a whole new level.
Sonia Singh is an artist in Australia. She's getting lots of attention for her Tree Change dolls.
You know, most of my life I've tried to remain quite anonymous, and I do get recognised in the street sometimes, and it's just a little bit crazy. I received interest from so many people around the world, and I'm just surprised that I have actually done something that seems to appeal to so many different people in different ways.
So Loz, here you are with a group of girls going through a tree change.
They didn't look real. Without any makeup, then it just looks really nice.
And what I really love to see is that people have not just been inspired by me, but that they've come up with their own take on it. And I think that's really, really wonderful to see my idea not just grow, but like branch out into different areas.
I am Radjrik Milroy woman, lived in Redfern community my whole life, and I paint dolls. I play with dolls. When I saw the video, I just thought I'll give it a go and try to make them look like, you know, beautiful black women that I know. Culturally appropriate dolls made by Aboriginal people aren't out there. And it really just sort of dawned on me just how important it is for children to see themselves in these dolls.
I'm in Sydney now, so it's going to be really lovely to meet Lorna in person and just talk to her about doll things. Hi, you must be Lorna.
Hello.
This is
Charlie. So smiley. Oh, Lorna, is this one of your dolls?
Yeah, that's one of them.
So soft. It's real fur. What is that?
It's possum skin. It's like traditionally they would have had images on the inside of the skins.
Okay. It's really nice to see you doing something that's not out there. It's great for people to realise that you can take some action yourself and, you know, you can change things. If we were like 8 years old, we would just be playing with these.
Probably stop. Are you going to have that one for a week?
Yeah.
I like this doll because it has kangaroo skin.
I like his hair. It looks like my brother.
It makes me feel happy that Aboriginal kids can have dolls that is based on their culture.
What I would love to see is just that little black girls and boys, you know, comes a realisation that they are special and that they are, you know, beautiful.
What Lorna's doing is really important because I've received lots of emails from people saying that they loved their dolls as a child but they never felt that any of the dolls looked like them, and how that affected their self-esteem.
I think at the moment there's a lot of things happening, you know, like you've had Mattel recently put out dolls that have different body shapes and things like that.
It's important for Barbies to look different. You know, like the real people in the world.
I think it's really interesting to see that I believe that I have had an influence on some of the major toy companies. Like, it's nothing that I can say for sure, but I can see that things are changing a little bit.
This one kind of looks like my friend Maggie.
This one looks like my friend Nan. Her name is Nan.
I think a lot of people find it surprising that this has turned into such a big thing. I mean, they're just dolls, but from all the responses I get, they just touch people's hearts, and dolls are really important to so many people. Even once we grow up, the toys we had as children, so I guess in the end they're not just dolls, they're something quite important to us all.